Barack Obama went on a TV chat show this week and said the changes he promised were not going to happen overnight. When he was elected, he said the climb ahead would be steep. But like a football manager after a string of bad results, it seems voters blame him. Let's talk to Charles Kupchan from Georgetown University and a former member of President Clinton's National Security Council. Is Obama to blame for his own predicament?
Well, it's clear that Obama was dealt a very bad hand to begin with. He had two wars, neither of them going well, a global economy and an American economy right on the edge of collapse, and then a divided country. Bush had polarized the United States in ways that we really haven't seen for many decades. And then Obama comes in, and I think he had some very clear successes on health care, on stabilizing the economy, making the United States more popular abroad. But in many respects, he hasn't gotten credit for some of these gains, mainly because the American economy hasn't picked up. Many Americans are feeling the pain, and they are blaming the president.
Foreign policy is your field, and you've said that he's courageous in, for instance, his approach to issues like Iran. Does that matter at all? Is it all down to the economy?
It is mostly about the economy right now, and that's because unlike in Europe, even though you have a downturn there, here the hit for the average American is really quite major. Unemployment, people are losing their houses, people are fearful for their savings, whether they can survive after they have retired. And that is really driving the political process. It's fueling the Tea Party. It is fueling the switch of independence from the Democratic column into the Democratic column. To the degree that foreign policy matters, it's focused largely on Iraq, and there Obama has succeeded in essentially sticking to his plea to begin downsizing. Afghanistan is a big question mark. The surge has gone ahead. It remains to be seen whether the new increment of American troops really makes a difference in terms of bringing the Taliban to wean.
So what picture is emerging of the U.S., would you say, at this time?
Well, I'm afraid it's a picture in which the United States faces some very, very serious challenges, particularly in terms of bringing down the deficit, but also in terms of foreign policy, dealing with Afghanistan, dealing with the rise of new powers and the loss of the material primacy of the West. But it doesn't look like the American political system is going to be in particularly good shape. I think Obama does need to recalibrate, does need to realize that if he gets things done, he has to work with a Congress that is likely to tilt in the Republican direction. Whether he can cobble together the necessary coalitions remains a big question mark, but I think that is going to be the agenda, finding enough common ground with the opposition so that Obama can begin to tackle the big domestic questions ahead. And I think those are really trying to get the economy to move forward, address unemployment, but also bring down the deficit, which is in the long run is a very serious threat, not just to the American economy, but to America's geopolitical position, which in the end rests upon its economic vitality.
Charles Kupchan in Washington, thanks very much for speaking to Euronews.